Officials of the Uganda Police Force, led by the Deputy IGP, Major General Geoffrey Katsigazito Musime, appeared before the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament to answer queries arising from the Auditor General's report of June 2022. However, legislators put it to police chiefs to explain the unfair distribution of police personnel by concentrating on guarding VIPs as other areas grapple with security presence.
Deployment, to my understanding, unless you can correct, individuals that receive those police officers to guard them, they pay money. They pay money for those services. Then, where does that money go?
Depending on the safety and security or insecurity around an individual. And that may differ from person to person.
In their defense, the Deputy Inspector General of Police revealed that most deployments are done under directives from above authorities with their hands tied.
Escorts or the escort detail per the appointment, the requirement of the appointment, or the instructions from various circles, depending on the security threats that they face. We get directives that it's so and so, give him two personnel, because he's facing some threat.
The legislators queried into the ridge in non-tax revenue collections, accusing police of under-budgeting. In the financial year under review, police budgeted to collect 24 billion shillings, but 33 billion shillings was collected at the end, which was highly attributed to enhanced enforcement by way of roadblocks.
Having realized that there were arrears of EPS arising from many years, right from 2014-15, we enhanced our collection through collaboration with the Uganda Revenue Authority. We put up roadblocks and we enforced the payment of arrears.
I want to find out whether actually their budgeting was proper and was smart. Because you see, the reasons are clear that led to that good performance.
However, MPs queried police revenue collection on realizing that revenues from police guards for banks performed at 50%, firearms rentals at 83%, while disposal of old vehicles performed at 11%. Legislators allege that some money collected from the three areas is not declared nor remitted to the consolidated fund.
Police guards given to banks, but you are receiving only 50%. What explains this? Where did the other money go? These are the people who have money, and they are demanding from everybody, taking security in terms of land from people, selling property. What happened? The firearms, who are the 17% who have not paid?
Recently, the Inspector General of Police suspended the operation of some private security organizations. And that was because of non-payment for the firearms that the police leases out to these private security organizations.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.